I'm going picture in picture this time just because I just woke up and I'm too lazy to lift my green screen. So here we are. Welcome to the real talk. Been a minute since I've done one of these because it needs a catalyst for it. And I have a good one because I was talking with somebody and they said something so perfect. And I took a second and I was like, damn.
Why have I never thought of it like that before? What the hell am I doing? Why has my brain not put together that same signal pattern for me?
So I want to talk about that big brain moment with you, and it's falling ass backwards into projects and things that ultimately end up helping you in life. I don't want to say success because it can be success, but not everything is measured by success, right? Like, I don't measure friendship by success. That's weird. I mean, I guess you could. So I wanted to get into a real talk, which is rare because I need a catalyst for them. I need to feel like I actually want to talk about something. Otherwise, it's just like the world's shortest and shittiest one-topic podcast. And for this one, I was talking, there's a lot of backstory, but I was talking with my therapist who I have been seeing for the greater part of the pandemic, and I highly recommend if you have the ability to and you're curious about trying it out, because I don't have any thing that I really wanted to go out and solve, but it's been really nice and eye-opening to have a different set of eyes on things. Ears, I guess, because we're not meeting in person. It doesn't matter. Point is, I was talking with them and I was trying to figure out why I was in this 3 to 4 week, I mean, still kind of am, just like this weird space where you just don't feel great about anything or terrible. Just kind of like muted, you know? It's been a long time since I felt the deep seated, that like really sharp excitement feeling, you know, where you're like, God, fucking tonight is Christmas Eve, you know, like that level. And because it's hard to do anything of that level of exciting here in the 10th month of lockdown. But I was like, man, I don't feel any of that. I'm just like, I feel really just sluggish and slothish. But nothing had changed in the last month. It was, if anything, a little bit better because we were through the stress of the holidays, through the part of the holidays where I was reminded that I can't see my family, all that jazz. I was like, well, what? I mean, I should be going up like fucking GameStop stocks right now. Like, what's going on? And we got talking back and forth, and I was talking about how I was hyper-focused on everything that I was doing on YouTube or on Instagram or on Twitch or on Twitter, like to the point where it's been a long time since I woke up and I've been like, all right, bros, we're gonna go check out the analytics tab. Like, I just don't care enough as long as like things seem to be going well at face value, and they have been. So I just don't check it normally. And then but I've been checking it every day for like a month at the time, and now still do, realizing like, I want to get back into caring about how well things are going, but at the same time, man, it kind of feels really shitty when you pay attention to all this stuff. Like I feel like I'm being drugged. Sure. But I feel like I'm being pulled in multiple directions, trying to figure out the best way to handle all this content. Make sure I got the hiccups. Make sure all the content is at its peak, is premium as possible, and I'm posting across everything. Like, it's stressful. And I was like, man, I never remember myself being so critical of the things that I was doing or second guessing some of the ideas that I've had that I've written down in my trusty little notebook. Just looking at it like the next day or 2 days after I've written it down, which is what I normally do, and just being like, fuck, stupid idea. Or maybe it's like not a good idea or as good idea as I thought I would, which normally I'd just be like, I don't care. Let's just try it out. And that was weird to me. And so this is the most interesting connection, but she was like, are you concerned that maybe you're focusing so much on this because it's kind of like all you got right now? I was like, well, yeah, I mean, it really is literally all I have to invest in. Whether I'm happy or sad kind of comes down to like, how is my YouTube video doing and how is Twitch going? Like, how is my stream today? Because there's nothing else to look forward to or do at all. And worrying about the success of and the level of success that you're having or I'm having with all of this stuff is taxing and helping me realize, alongside all of the reasons why I am a social person who likes to go out in large groups and meet new people. I thrive in areas where I have to meet new people. And it's just like, especially if there's some mutual interest, like at a show or something like that, and haven't been able to do that. And we locked it down to one major thing that has changed that probably has caused a whole lot of me feeling kind of hypercritical about stuff that I'm doing, spending too much attention looking at the negative details. And also, one of the big reasons why I feel so, like such a fucking drained husk of a creator. And it's that I haven't fallen ass backwards into anything good recently. You don't understand that that's not a negative thing, okay? When I was growing up, and still do to this day, when somebody asked me, what's my life plan? I'm like, oh shit, you guys have those? I didn't get that from the bookstore. No, but what's your life plan to me for a long time meant, what are you guaranteeing that you're doing in every step of your life? Like, in every step of the way, what are you doing? And if you don't have a life plan, when asked, like, what are you really an adult? And I'm like, oh, you know what you're doing August 13th when you're 57? That's sick. Honestly, I don't know. I'm making dinner tonight. That's cool. And it always kind of made me feel, and I think a lot of people are that way, it makes you feel like you are the one that doesn't have shit together. And for that same reason, falling ass backwards into things makes it sound like you ain't got your shit together and you just got lucky. And you know what? Pretty much, a lot of the things that make me happy today happen because I fell ass backwards into them. And it's not that I did everything perfectly and got 9 internships or wrote letters to the newspaper to get in contact with the right people. It's that I accidentally, or by chance, or by the fate of the universe, or thanks to SpongeBob SquarePants, whatever you want to blame it on, like, ended up in a position where something happened and I was able to capitalize that in some way. And what I mean by that is, like, night mode. The record label would not have existed if I just hit the shit out of my book. Would not have existed if I hadn't moved from Portland down to LA again. It wouldn't have existed if I had never met Daniel. If Daniel had never asked if I wanted to curate an album with Disciple Records. It would never have existed if I didn't spend a meticulous amount of time going to every single live show in Los Angeles for 4 years, in order to end up meeting as many people as possible and honestly becoming great friends with a lot of them. Like, these things all stem from me being a social person and getting into these situations where, like, that's where I'm at, baby. I like social situations. I like being able to read people's body language. I like being able to understand, like, at least better if what I'm saying is interesting to somebody versus cold emailing someone, right? Like, there's a level of intimacy that you get, obviously, with a person-to-person stuff that you can't replicate digitally. Like, not in a Zoom call or any shit like that. And it throws me off, and it's throwing me off. And there's been no opportunities for me to sit there and capitalize on accidentally ending up in a situation where maybe, like, something fun or interesting is going to happen. And because that distraction doesn't exist, every couple weeks where I'm like, that's a new business idea, or that's a really good content idea, or yes, I'd like to go to this party in this random area with these people I don't know. Like, because of all of that, it's in turn kind of made me focus all of that energy inward on the shit that I do have control over and can actually pay attention to right now, which is YouTube and Twitch and all the social media shit. And that is kind of how, in some weird fashion, I believe that my inability to go and fall ass backwards into some interesting thing to divert some of my attention to is inadvertently, or not inadvertently, is directly contributing to how whack I feel and how, like, shitty and, like, unsatisfied with the things that I'm doing currently are, because I feel like it's in turn made me hypercritical of all the things that I'm doing. And instead of being able to kind of, like, spread myself thin and do a bunch of stuff and not worry about the small details. Small details is all I got right now, man. It's all I got. I got these tiny little details. And I did want to kind of, and I feel stagnant. I do. I feel stagnant now. And so that's why I'm making a second YouTube channel. Ah, you heard it here. I mean, a third one. Whatever. AFK is dead. I'm making another one for, like, additional content and, like, I need to do something else. I need to do something else. I need to be busy. My hands need to be busy, and there's too much, like, shit. I need to see some green numbers somewhere. So, yeah, I don't know. And how I wanted to also tie this back in again to the whole life plan thing. Like, you, I'm sure that when you think about it, some of your friendships, some of your relationships, some of your favorite moments in life have strictly come down to you accidentally doing something or meeting someone or by chance or by whatever thing you want to say, you end up in an unlikely scenario and then end up having that affect your life in some positive fashion. And it happens a shit ton. It's happened to a lot of my friends, business connections, YouTube, Twitch, everything success-wise, like, all comes back to some chance meeting somewhere and how you handle it. So I miss that. I miss social. We're on the end of this long, long trip, and I am thankful. Oh, God. I think I just ranted for... I think I didn't even stop talking for, like, 10 minutes. I'm sorry. But also, thanks for watching. If you guys want that second channel, I'll post it in the description. I'm uploading single-player games there, and also uploading things that wouldn't necessarily fit on the main channel, like VR, random VR stuff, just chatting shit. Just, it's like the extra content channel. Maybe we'll put premium internet, Zillow, whatever. So, thanks for hanging. I'll talk to you guys later.